Hello everyone, I'm Noemi Maurer and I'm from the University of Torino, and this work has been done in collaboration with Liliana Ardissone and Federica Cena, and today we are going to present a personalized recommender system of point of interest to people with autism. In order to provide truly inclusive services, recommender system have to take into account different factors instead of only considering user preferences and interests. In particular, when we are suggesting point of interest to people with autism, we should take into account at least three aspects. First, we have to deal with the data scarcity problem because people with autism are a small fraction of the population. Then we have to consider idiosyncratic sensory aversion to avoid stress and anxiety, but we also have to take into account interest to please the users. People with autism have particular special needs. In particular, in literature, there are work that say that 90% of people with autism show a typically sensory perception. This because the brain seems unable to appropriately balance the senses. Because of this, people with autism are able to enjoy a reduced range of activities and interests, and they usually prefer mechanical deterministic situations with rigid routines. People with autism tend to avoid places that may negatively impact on their senses because their high sensory stimulation could negatively influence them in their movements. The sensory aversion may result in anxiety, fatigue, sense of oppression, or distraction. Our proposal is the development of a recommender system for people with autism that takes into account user preferences and aversion in feature-based user profiles for the suggestion of safe point of interest. Our work is framed in the PUMA project. The project is the aim to develop digital solutions for helping people with autism in their everyday movements and life. The final results of this project will be a mobile app that shows customized maps for people with autism. To develop the recommender system, we had first to define the user model. The user model contains the user preferences that have been elicited about categories of point of interest, such as the interest in restaurants, parks, and so forth, and then the user aversion that have been elicited with a short questionnaire about aversion for feature with low or high levels. In particular, we asked to the user, for example, how much does it bother you, too much light, a lot of noise, etc. This data have been elicited with a questionnaire, but in the future, this part will be integrated in the registration phase of the PUMA app. For what concerns the ratings, we elicited the user ratings with a questionnaire and in which we asked to the people to rate 50 specific points of interest located in the Torino city center, and we gave to the user the option also to say that they don't know the place. This part will be also integrated in the PUMA app, so people will be able to rate the point of interest directly in the mobile app. In order to define the point of interest sensory feature value, we use a crowdsourcing platform called Maps for All that allows the user to rate the point of interest sensory feature in a scale that goes from 1 to 5. They have the possibility to rate, for example, the brightness, the noise, the smell of a place, and etc. To collect ratings, preferences, and idiosyncratic aversion, we involved two groups of users. The first one concerned 20 people with autism belonging to the Autistic Adult Center of the city of Torino. And then we involved 128 neurotypical subjects that are from the university and the Autos contacts. To develop the recommender system, we had first to define a model to compute the user aversion to the item sensory feature. The first case is the case in which we have a feature that the higher is the value of the feature, the stronger is its negative impact on the user, for example, the noise. So we define Vmax as the maximum value of the Likert scale, and then we define AUF Vmax, that is the user aversion for the maximum value of the feature. As we can see in the picture, we can draw a line that connects the minimum aversion for the minimum value of the feature to the maximum aversion of the user for the maximum value of the feature. As we can see in the figure, we draw a blue thick line that shows the user aversion to the possible value of F. We then had to define the user aversion to a specific feature value of a specific item for a user U. So by considering the example represented in the figure, if we consider the feature value of the item I that is equal to 3, and then we go to see the user aversion for this value on the vertical axis that is represented by the orange circle, we can see that the corresponding value is 2.5. So for the feature value of 3, the user aversion will be 2.5. The second case is the case in which we have a feature that the extreme value of the feature makes the user uncomfortable while the middle values are less problematic. For example, really bright places or really dark places. Again, we have Vmax that is the maximum value of the Likert scale, and then we have the AUF Vmax and the AUF min that represent the user aversion for the maximum or the minimum value of the feature. So in this case, we have the blue line that represents a feature in which if the feature value increases, also the user aversion increases. And then we have the green line in which if the feature values increases, the user aversion decreases. To define the user aversion to the feature F of an item I for a specific value and for a specific user, we decided to take into account the maximum aversion corresponding to the green and the blue line. So for example, if we have feature value of 3, we are going to notice that we have the violet circle that represents the user aversion for the feature value of 3 on the blue line and correspond on the vertical axis to the value 2.5. And then we have the orange circle that corresponds to the user aversion on the green line that is equal to 2, and by taking the maximum value, we will have a user aversion for the feature value of 2.5. We decided to take the maximum aversion because we wanted to be more conservative, since if the user aversion is really high for a case, the user could be really uncomfortable and could show a lot of stress. Until now, we talk about user aversion, but we are interested in suggesting to the user point of interest that have high compatibility with them. So we convert the discomfort or aversion in compatibility. For example, if we have a user aversion of 2, we will have a user compatibility of 4. After having computed the compatibility of each feature for the item, we had to define the overall compatibility of an item for a user. So we define different features aggregation measure. The first one is the min one that defines the compatibility of an item for a user U by taking into account the minimum compatibility between all the features. The second one is the average ones that define the compatibility of an item for a user U as the average of the compatibility of all the features. And then we define two other feature aggregation measures that are based on the concept of the distance. So we considered an ideal vector that represents an ideal item which best matches the user idiosyncrasies. And then we have the vector I that contains the feature values of an item I. The first measure is the Cosine measure, that is the distance between the feature values of I and those of an ideal item which best matches the idiosyncrasies of the user. And then we have the complement of the root mean square deviation between the feature values of I and those of an ideal item. After that, we had to define how we compute the rating prediction. So we developed the IND recommender. IND is a model that identifies a specific alpha value for each user to optimize item recommendation to him. In particular, IND takes into account two different components. The first one concerns the preference in the item category, and the second one contains the compatibility between the item and the user. And then we have an alpha parameter that have the aim to balance these two components for the individual user. Then we compared our model with three different baselines. The first one is a multi-criteria recommender system that uniformly treats item compatibility and preferences. The second one is a recommender system that evaluates item exclusively on the basis of their compatibility with the user. And the third one only consider the preferences of the user. We compared our recommender with the baseline on two datasets, the first one that has been collected from the autistic people and the second one on the neurotypicals one. We performed a five-fold cross-validation, and for the in the recommender system, we optimized the alpha parameters with respect to the mean average precision. We computed the typical matrix for the evaluation of a recommender system. We have to notice that we tested each recommender system by considering the four aggregation measures between the compatibility of the features. The IND-COSE recommender system is the IND recommender system that has as aggregation measure the Cosin similarity. This recommender system excels in accuracy and ranking capabilities, while IND-MIN excels in error minimization. PREF-ONLY is the best baseline regarding mean average precision, and we notice that the configuration of the multi-criteria recommender system has middle to low performance. We achieved similar results for neurotypical users, but you can see the details in the paper. Overall, we noticed that the compatibility information or the preference information alone are not enough to generate relevant recommendation for users. However, if we use a personalized balance between the compatibility and the user preferences, we can see an increase in the recommendation performance. We notice this both for people with autism and the neurotypical people. We can say that the integration of possibly heterogeneous evaluation criteria concerning user interest and the idiosyncratic aversion is promising for inclusive recommender system. As future work, we plan to extend the information about point of interest by carrying out different VGI campaigns with people with autism and their caregivers, as well as with the general population to acquire a larger amount of data. And we also plan to extract sensory information from customer reviews available in online platforms such as TripAdvisor. For what concerns the mobile app, we plan to integrate the IND recommender system in the Puma app. We plan to learn detailed information about user interest and aversion based on the analysis of user behavior. And our final goal is to test the mobile app in the city of Torino with people with autism. Thank you for your attention.